I have my own company, Passionfruit Education. We do personal development workshops, produce personal development literature. Carol is incredibly clever. I think Kelly's probably the most beautiful spirit I have seen. My respect for Ryan grows every second. So Catherine is a phenomenally difficult person to connect with. She does that on purpose. Tremendous intellect. Liam's working really hard to make this project happen. Like, I'm so impressed with the way he's got this project to where it is.
And where you gay? Because some guy took advantage of you. Can you see that for the crop of shit it is?
What's happened to all of us isn't that bad, are they? These guys are just going through one of a million other therapy sessions they've been through.
So how long are you going to go on torturing your mum?
But when you throw shock factor in there, you touch a nerve. And when you touch a nerve, you begin to be able to drill into what the truth is. Is the solution to dealing with trauma in your life to be in control or to be vulnerable? So drop everything. No matter what has happened in the past, there's no white flag. I'm not a victim to this shit anymore. I am so steadfastly, determinedly moving forward, leaving my excuses behind, and they're valid excuses, like really valid, but I'm not having the person who abused me all those years ago still abusing me in the future. I leave that behind. No white flag. I have had enough of feeling shit ass. I've had enough of feeling bad. I've had enough of anxious, sleepless, hurtful, resentful, angry, uptight, emotionally vulnerable living. I don't need it anymore. I don't want to surrender to that stuff. I'm going to surrender to my future. The future for people like you guys is really bright. So what does that mean for people who don't have to carry the baggage? What it does, it takes away the excuses for those people. Just takes them away. And realistically, we need to take our own excuses away.
We love you. This space is safe. We love you.
These kids do not have to accept the responsibility of them. Don't need to accept the responsibility of being people. They do need to accept the responsibility of
being. I choose to do this work. I know of the pain that these young people experience. What gives the society the right to curtail a young person's voice in a courtroom so that the onus of proof is on the young person, so that the story has to be told by the young person in sanitised terms?
If you cry, not only does it show your vulnerability, but it will give them the power to see that they're there.
Put yourself into a frame of mind where nobody's watching. It's just you, your seven-year-old self, and the future. All judgment is gone. You are open, beautiful, strong, with the mirror, you get to see inside your own soul. What you love is the person that you become as a result of that. And you can genuinely say, yeah, I love that person. I know that through the abuse has no more power over you.
And I won't put my hands up and surrender. There will be no white flag above my door. I'm in love and always will be.